Welcome to day 9 of the Metazoo Nightfall release event boxes! Choose your battlefield. First edition. If you haven't heard, Metazoo has a... Well, it's actually all over the game, but it has a special fourth wall. Who do we got? Last day. Alright, we got three of these guys. If you haven't heard, it has a unique fourth wall element. And what does that mean? That means that certain times... Oh, this guy's from Canada. Cool. Certain cards have a fourth wall element, which basically just means they do something if a element of outside of the game happens. So if it's snowing, this happens. Or if it's raining, this happens. And that's one of the reasons why people cite that Metazoo's game is just a little weird or standoffish or... I don't know how I'd play. You know, people like fair things. If they're going to spend their time on it, they want it to be fair. Well, I've got good news for people that think that. Metazoo has a piece of paper that you write down your fourth wall elements on. This is the current structure of the tournament setting. And if you can only use those elements, quote unquote, like fourth wall elements, period. It doesn't matter if you're wearing socks or it's snowing out or you're by, you know, whatever, Chicago. You just write it down. And so don't worry about the game not being fair if that is your concern. They've got it figured out and they are able to have tournaments in a fair way. And it's pretty strategic because you can pick fourth wall elements that counter opponents too. All right. This will determine the pace of the whole box. Ah, we're not ending with veggies, are we? Come on, baby. It's fine. It's fine. I always wanted three veggie men. It's what I dreamed about as a kid. These packs are from Texas. These release event boxes. And I have found a pattern that has stayed true. 9 boxes deep. The pattern has stayed true. The pattern is dun 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 dun. Shocking reveal. What up, pumpkins? What's pumpkins doing? Mothman pumpkin. If you never noticed, I just noticed. Oh wait, let's see this hit, and then I'll tell you about the pattern. Okay, this is the perfect time to tell you about a squink. This is the perfect time to tell you about the pattern. On day 9, the last day, this pattern has held up all 8 days before today, and we are about to find out if it will hold up in day number 9. The pattern is, if you get 2 reverse hollows, you will get a third, no matter what. And that is held up. Aura Powers, Land Attacks, Frostbite, Jack-O-Lantern, Bloody Bones, Spectre Moose. Oh, yeah, okay. I wasn't sure about the other pack that the other day this got messed up, but I'm sure about it today. So we have that replacing one of the silvers. And, oh my gosh, we have broken our theory on day number 9. Let's see if there's any errors in here. 1, 2, 3. Nope, just one of the silvers got replaced. We have broken our theory. We are wrong, and we will admit it. We're not going to double down or dig in or try to backpedal or explain things. So the theory was that you could not get one full hollow. You could either get 2 full hollows or 3 reverse hollows. And now we have broken that pattern. So all bets are off on these release event boxes from Texas, Tejas. That is day number 9, and you know what I think I'm going to do? We're going to do a little recap. Not an opening, a recap tomorrow. We're going to go over all of the decks, we're going to go over all the hits, and I'm going to talk about how day number 9 busted my theory that was holding up. All right, have a good one, guys.